Welcome, my viewers and my listeners of the program. Celebrate your moment with joy. I'm your presenter, Pastor Florence Minor, and I'm bringing this message live all the way from Minnesota, USA. On this special day, to that mother out there, whether you have gotten your biological children or not, if you are female, you are mother. You have been made to mother something. And I want to wish you a very happy Mother's Day today. If you have not heard it from anybody else, hear it. I already posted very early in the morning wishing you a very happy Mother's Day on Facebook. And I want to refer to that message that I gave on Facebook about the acronym of the word mother, even as I gave it. And I know you'll be blessed. We are going to be blessed together in Jesus' name. And see if I can get it, but we are going to start also with a word of prayer. Just give me a second here. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you for this day that was set aside for a mother to be given the respect and good wishes. I want to pray, oh God, for that woman out there who might be so much expecting and maybe have not received anything or have not seen any guests. May they know that you have visited them. I thank you, dear Lord, even as I share your word, oh God. As I demonstrate what you've given me, dear Lord, I pray that King of Kings, somebody will be encouraged out there in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. I want to base my encouragement to you on Romans 6, verse 23, the last part, but I'm going to read the entire. It says this, For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Happy Mother's Day. Why should I read this? Because every mother or woman, sometimes, you know, most of the time on Mother's Day, you're expecting maybe somebody to wish you a mother's happy Mother's Day or bring you a card or bring you a gift. Wait a minute. I want to tell you, I have a message for you. I have a gift for you, a gift message for you from heaven, from God himself. He says that the gift of God is eternal life. The best gift you can receive, my fellow mother, my fellow woman, is the free gift of life. Can you imagine? You are breathing. You are breathing and you are breathing the air that you cannot be able to pay. If you have been given the bill to pay for that air, I don't know how many people would be able to pay. Actually, there is a song that I have recorded. It's not yet out. That if you are given, if you are to be given the bill of the air that you breathe, how would you be able to pay? You would not be able to pay. And here I am. I got what I was looking for. A mother. Okay. One. M is a motivator. We must be women, mothers who can motivate young mothers, our own children, whether they will listen or not, because at some point the Holy Spirit will do the quickening and remind them what they heard from you. The other thing, a mother is an organizer. You must organize your life. Let me be specific here. I do not specifically mean organizing your closet, organizing your kitchen, organizing your bedroom, organizing your house, organizing your car. Those counts. But I'm trying to say, you organize your life. You organize your priorities. What is your first priority? Organize your relationship with God as a mother. On this Mother's Day, please listen to me. We can be caught up with so many things, like the way mother was caught up in preparation. Many women, most of the percentage, we are caught up in preparation. I want to thank God for Pastor Pauline. Now she lives in Seattle. She relocated there. She really gave me an advice. Pastor Pauline, my colleague, remember, I really thank God for you. You really gave me a deliverance statement that you told me, Florence, if a woman ever wait to finish what she's supposed to do in the house, she'll never move out of the house. And it is true. If you're a woman there and you ever finish your housework, please let us know and be honest. Okay. Now, that was the for letter O. T, tolerance. A mother must be tolerant. Remember when you started changing the diapers, and immediately when you change, that infant has pooped again. I'm gonna give a story of my son. I know he may not like it, but it's the truth. I'm the mother anyway. So and was changing him, you know, boys. And after I was done, and maybe he felt like he was being massaged, he peed on me straight into the mouth and the face. We must be tolerant. Could I slap him? No, I had to be tolerant with him. Our children may mess up. Our children may not meet our expectation, you know, at the moment. But we must be tolerant with them. The worst thing you can do as a mother is to throw your children away there. And I always say this, and I want to thank God for my paternal grandmother who went to be with the Lord after she had lived long. She was over 100 years. And she always used to teach me a lot of things about patience. So, and she would talk to my dad who rested not long ago. He would tell him, not only him, even the other kids. My dad was the firstborn. Do not sell that goat or whatever or that tree there. And they would listen. Even if they did not listen, you know she had done her part. As a mother, don't give up on telling your children what is right. Whether they are going to ignore you or not, it is okay. You know, my children can tell. There are many times I tell them something and they don't listen right away. And later on they say, oh, now we understand what mom meant. So we must be tolerant. H, helping hand to all. We must be ready to offer a helping hand. Like now, when I woke up in the morning, I had so many, actually taking a nap because I worked overnight before I went to church. I so had so many messages. I did not even dare to look at them because I would be ready to go to church, you know. And we must be able to help. We be a helping hand to all that come to us. Even though I did not respond, I'm going to be responding to those messages and those who have sent me and they have not replied. Please bear with me. Be patient with me. I have so many of them. Well, in one of the phone, I saw like I had 137 messages. Imagine when I'm going to finish them. Oh, a helping hand to all. Okay. Now, and you can also refer to Proverbs, that one, that woman is also caring to the poor. He's like a mother is always like a never ready machine. You remember those batteries? Ever ready batteries. You must be ever ready for anything. Be ready for anything. You know, I am a mother of three. And to be honest, my third one, I was pregnant for 3 months. I did not even know I was pregnant. Be expected, be ready. You are like a never ready machine. There are those messages you are gonna hear all of a sudden, and you are really, oh, your child may just come and surprise you with some messages. I know my son, my older son, has a tendency to look for a moment and say, Mom, I have something. And he's not so soft until these days when he started that I'm almost guessing there is something surprising I'm going to be told. We must be like a never-ready machine to receive. When you receive those messages, know how you filter them. It's like a filing system. Know how to file them. You know, my kids know I can be a little bit tough, and sometimes they refer, Mom, you have always said this, but you know, because we are like ever-ready machine, we must be tolerant. Depending on what we get, we must be ready to incubate and be able to safeguard what our children tells us. And then number, you know, letter R, rewards, mother always rewards her memories for others or for all. I can't tell you how many times my kids will misplace things and they come asking me, Mom, have you seen this and that? Oh, Mom, did you see this? Did you take this? Why? It's like they rely on your memory. You are like that machine. So mother, that mother, be encouraged. And now, the reason I read Romans 6:23 is because there is a gift that God has given you. But until you open, you may not be able to know what it is. The word has told us in Romans that the gift of God is eternal life for you. God has given you eternal life. Now, when I was going to church, actually that girl had already called me, but I did not see because, as I said, I took a nap after working. And I later on, after church, is when I saw she had called me earlier. And so I had a bell ring, and I'm preparing myself to go to church. So I just left, you know, and I'm opening the door. Yeah. It is this lady. Guess what? This is a gift. I've not even opened it, honestly. Not ignorance, but I wanted need to give it the full attention, a Mother's Day gift. What am I saying? I'm comparing it with Romans 6:23. Until you open the word of God and know that God has given you the gift of eternal life, you may not know there is a gift for you. There is a gift of peace that surpasses all human understanding from God the Father. There is a peace, there is a gift of you knowing that they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with eagles. They shall run and not be weary. Yes, this is a gift. I've not yet opened. Not until you open the word of God and know the promises that God has for you, that he has a bright future for you. Then I went to church and every mother was receiving this. You know, God bless my church, Grace Fellowship. Every woman was receiving this. I have not even opened it, but there was a message that God gave me. That's why I did not open them right away. Not until you open the word of God and realize that God loves you so much that you are fearfully and wonderfully created. So even as I'm wishing you a happy Mother's Day, I don't just want to send you the flowers that I'm going to Google from Google images. Of course I did that, but I wanted to give you that, you know, full dish of being a mother, of what to expect. No, there is more than being wished a happy Mother's Day by being given that card. If I get it, it's okay. If I don't get it, already I've gotten it. You see, then God surprises that. Sometimes you could be expecting from your children, but God is coming through other children. I don't know yet whether my children are going to bring me the gift or not. I have no idea if they bring or embrace. If they don't, I have already, you know, received not only that. I started appreciating, and if you go back to my messages, I've encouraged every woman. Don't be so much expectant from one head, from your children, from your husband. What they don't give you, what are you going to do? I'm reminding you that you are fearfully and wonderfully made, that you have gotten the free gift of eternal life from our Father in heaven. And so, I'll be opening this. Wow. So, and as I open, I know God will be able to, I'll even get so much excited. But let me finish up this message. But I wanted to tell you, until you open the word of God and know that message that is there for you, you will not know, and you're going to live a frustrated life as a mother. We don't want to live to live a frustrated life. Last but not least, there is a message I received yesterday, 12:12 p.m. from another group I am in, and I read it today after church. I'm going to be posting it on Facebook. If possible, I can post it together with this message. Please don't ignore. Every mother, let us hide our children in the blood of Jesus per Psalms 91. One of the servant of God I love, Rachel Chege from Chicago, has sung, "Ashiarito hide shianasi itoda kama ine ya Jesu," because there is a lot of danger. That message is like a warning. Don't just take it easily. Don't take it lightly. Don't ignore it. Let us pray for our children. If you can call, we pray together. You know, it is always good to pray before midnight and after midnight. If you can spend at least 30 minutes, like 11:45 to 12:15, it is very, very good. You end up the day in the presence of God and start off the day in the presence of the Lord. Happy Mother's Day. And know there is a gift for you in the word of God. Actually, there are so many gifts for you as a mother. Genesis 3:20 says that she shall be called the mother of all the living. You carry them that are living, not dead. Anything vibrant there has been brought forth by a woman. Father, in the name of Jesus, I want to wish again every woman out there a happy Mother's Day. Let them be encouraged to know, not until they open that gift, they will not know what is there. May that woman open the word to know that they that wait upon the Lord renew their strength, that you are their shepherd, you are their provider, you are their comforter. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Now, according to the word that I read, I want to encourage you, woman, you mother, you, if you have never given your life to God, this is the time. On Mother's Day, you declare and decree that you have belonged to Jesus. It's going to be the best gift for yourself. You want to say this prayer after me if you're in that category. Lord Jesus, I come before you. I want to repent of my sins. Write my name in the book of life and give me a desire to grow spiritually, and let me accept the gift that you've given me of eternal life, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. If you have prayed that prayer, by faith you've been transformed from a sinner to a saint. Behold, now you are a new creature. Start walking in the newness of life. Associate yourself. Plug yourself into a group of believers that teach the word of God without compromise for your spiritual growth. Also, let me know when you have that you have accepted the Lord, and will continue to rejoice with you. I love you, and God loves you the most. Remember to subscribe to my channel of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy, and to celebrate every moment with joy, because every moment you are breathing in and breathing out is a moment for you, is a reason and moment for you to tell God thank you. Bye for now, and I'll be opening my gift.